Environmental issues and problems have dimensions. The CUE must adopt holistically all levels of stakeholders such as the government, the public, elites, activists, NGOs, and other environmental groups. However, the government have wide opportunities to affect policies and perfect all forms of market-oriented approaches and incentives to help manage the environment. Good evening, Honorable Jury and members of the House. Today, I, Aryan Locha from DAV Public School Sector 14, Gurugram, shall be presenting my views on the motion, controlling air pollution is the responsibility of only the government and not the citizens of the nation. I firmly believe in this motion as emissions of greenhouse gases of human origin are the main cause of climate change. The effects on global warming are so devastating and it is becoming more and more urgent that these emissions are reduced to stop the humans from exercising so much pressure on the planet. The situation is so critical that the International Energy Agency, IEA, has a forecast an increase in the emissions of 130% by 2050 if we continue unabated. Governmental policies of the top five major polluters in the world clearly show how the elected government of these countries have failed to reduce the emissions from the government sectors. If they themselves are failing to cut down the emissions of the government sectors, how can they expect the general public and the private sector to do their part? Countries like People's Republic of China, United States of America, and the Indian Republic, who are responsible for a major part of these emissions, have either not ratified the Kyoto Protocol, which is the only legally binding treaty for the reduction of carbon emissions, or have been exempted merely because they classify as quote-unquote developing nations. The government of these countries expect the general citizens to control their emissions. But if the government sectors are themselves failing to curb pollution and are acting like hippo global level, they should not expect the general public to cut down their usage. A survey was conducted by US Environmental Protection Agency, and it has been proven that government sectors and the state and private companies are responsible for more than 60% of the emissions worldwide. I would like to quote some examples of the state-owned private companies which are major shareholders in the global emissions. ExxonMobil Corporation, which is an American multinational oil and gas corporation headquartered in Irving, Texas. Then there's Coal India Limited, which is an Indian state-owned coal mining and refinery company headquartered in Kolkata, West Bengal. Then there's China National Petroleum Corporation, CNPC, which is a major national oil and gas corporation of People's Republic of China and one of the largest integrated energy groups of the world. I would like to conclude by saying that change should begin from the very top. Government should act like a role model to its citizens and not expect them to achieve things which themselves couldn't. A government can take multiple steps like greening of the health sector, build safe, affordable, and eco-friendly public transport system. They can also work towards investing in energy-efficient power generation and also improve waste management techniques. A collective effort is required for solving environment-related problems, and every individual must contribute to this noble cause. The government must frame policies so as to reduce the environmental emissions, and the use of sustainable technologies can also be quite beneficial and can be promoted through research and development activities. The corporates should also take initiatives in this regard, and companies should take inspiration from private companies like BMW, Adidas, Biogen, striving to reduce their emissions. And in overall, we as human beings must act responsibly at local and international levels. We ought to fight for clean air today for a better tomorrow. That will be all. Thank you for being such a great audience.